do that.
Okay, in the sample project, I'm going to create a rug material for this. If we would watch this material in our Enscape project, for example, in this place, we have a rug. Maybe it is good for some kind of rugs that are not very kind of fair or hairy. But for some rugs, we need more height for this material. Maybe you can use displacement materials or other kind of bone maps, but you wouldn't get any much realistic material. But with this tip that I'm going to mention, you can render the carpet materials very easily. The only thing you can do, the only thing you should do is to use two keywords. We can simulate two kind of rugs or carpet materials in our Revit project with usage of Enscape. The first one is short carpet and the second one is long carpet. And the only thing when you are creating your material, you should know is to put that word in the material name. For example, let me select this, click on edit type, and from here, carpet inside. Let me create a material with short carpet name, short carpet name or short carpet word in it. Test one. Okay, it is good for me, and just click OK and OK. You just need to wait and let Enscape to update the material. And you can see we have a very, really good material here. Maybe you want to change the color. The only thing you need to do is to go to the material editor and change the color in appearance tab. From here, let me put it on maybe on this color to see it clearly. You can see it very great. And also let me change it another time. Click on apply and you can see the results. Okay, so now you can create some rugs with just one color. Let me test the long carpet first and we use some textures for it too. Let me create a new material again and let me name it with long carpet keyword test 2 and click on here. Let me change it to maybe gray is okay for this purpose and click on OK and click on apply and let us see the change. You should give Enscape some time to update it and see the results. Now you can see it is much longer in comparison with the last one. Okay, but sometimes, for example, you need some carpets like this. Not exactly like this, but with some textures. It is just a usage for showing you how to use textures. I mean, it doesn't work specifically with this patch. For example, let me select carpet again and click on edit type, and in the carpet material, maybe I'm going to use it with short carpet. And from here, assign the image to it that I'm going to upload it in on my Patreon. You can download it from there. And also let me change the scale to maybe 300 and click on down, click on OK, and from here click on OK and give Enscape some time to update it according to our new material. Now you can see we have a material with some patterns on it, and also you can change the scale again to maybe achieve to other kind of results, better results, or something that you have in your mind for the material. Maybe let me put it on 600. Click on down, down, and okay. Now you can see the patterns much clearly, and you can see the carpet here too. It is great. I love Enscape with for the simplicity. Now let me change the material again. From here, let me put it on maybe on 800, a little bit bigger. Click on done, okay, and apply. Now you can see you can achieve a very, very high quality rug with some tips that I've showed you in this video. It is great in comparison with other kind of ways that you can achieve to these materials. In some older versions, these tips doesn't work, and you need to do the same thing and use grass material for this purpose. Well, but for newer versions of Enscape, you can do this tip and achieve more realism on your renderings.